What is it?
A déjà vu is usually a glitch in the matrix.
What's the difference between déjà rêve and déjà vu? Well, let's break them down real quick. Déjà vu means already seen, while déjà rêve means already dreamed. It's meant to describe the sensation that what you're currently experiencing is a scene, a memory, or simply a feeling from something that you've dreamt previously. It's probably been confused for déjà vu in the past, but the researchers state that this is due to the lack of understanding and vocabulary around experiential phenomena. For most, the feeling of, I've experienced this before, is immediately associated with déjà vu. But this study is meant to show that there are actually a few categories of this phenomena that are fundamentally different. Technically, even déjà vu is mainly misunderstood. While it does technically translate to already seen, recent studies have shown that this is a misleading name because you definitely have not seen the thing before. It's actually just like a memory miscommunication in the brain. It blurs the feeling of subjective familiarity with an objectively new event. Basically, déjà vu is just recalling something that has similar-ish details to something that's currently happening and mislabeling the feeling as a premonition or a vision from a past life or something way more exciting than it actually is. The reason déjà rêve is so mysterious is that, unlike déjà vu, when experiencing déjà rêve, you actually are recalling a vision or feeling you had while dreaming, but during waking consciousness. It might start to sound like the ramblings of a dude on LSD, but there's actual science to back it up. This study, published in the journal Brain Stimulation, showed that this sensation can be properly identified, studied, and located specifically in certain regions of the brain. So let's get into the abstract. The study involved both performing experiments on subjects to try to study déjà rêve and researching other studies over the past 60 years to try to find evidence of recorded déjà rêve. For the purposes of their experiments, the researchers were only interested in feelings of déjà rêve that could be induced. The subjects all suffer from partial epilepsy and had all reported experiencing some form of déjà rêve in the past, often during seizures. After signing an informed consent form, they were all administered electrical brain stimulation, known as EBS, to various parts of their brain, and any abnormal responses were recorded. Here's what they found. Not only were they able to induce and identify déjà rêve, they were able to classify it into three different categories. The first, episodic-like déjà rêve. This is the most lucid form, and it involves the subject remembering a specific dream in the experience, even being able to identify when they had it. One patient reported seeing the same room that they had specifically dreamt about two nights before, but the main characteristic that they saw during the déjà rêve that they remembered from the dream was the color orange. The second, familiarity-like déjà rêve. This is any déjà rêve that involves elements from a dream that the subject finds familiar without being able to pinpoint the specific dream or date. Here's an excerpt from one of the patients who experienced this type. Age 12, be warned, it's super creepy.
Yes, I have seen something. I've already seen it. Something I've seen in a dream. It was shapes.
Is it an object or a scene with people?
A scene. There was a person in the back of the room. The back of the room was yellow.
Was it moving or was the person static?
The person was moving. It was like a short movie.
Did you know that person?
No, but I had the feeling I've already seen her.
Did you see her face?
Yes.
Okay, if that's not the creepiest thing that a 12-year-old could ever say, I don't know what is. The final type, and the most mysterious, is dreamy state déjà rêve. This occurs when the feeling of déjà rêve is accompanied by a feeling of actually being in a dream, or at least a feeling similar to that of night dreaming. So basically, the line between reality and dreams starts to blur. In their actual study, a subject only experienced this type once. But in their research into the history of déjà rêve, it was by far the most common. After collecting the data, the researchers also found that the different types of déjà rêve were activated by different regions of the brain. All three types were activated by performing EBS on the temporal lobes, but specifically, inducing episodic-like déjà rêve was focused on the medial temporal lobes, familiarity-like déjà rêve was spread throughout the temporal lobes, and dreamy state déjà rêve was mostly found in the lateral neocortex. This evidence implies that this phenomenon can be pinpointed to specific areas of the brain, which can lead to further research and understanding of not only déjà rêve, but déjà vu, epilepsy treatments, and experiential phenomena as a whole. So the next time you find yourself stopped in a moment of déjà vu, check to see what's actually happening. Is the event simply something that feels very similar to a past event, or are you experiencing a lucid vision of a dream you had recently? Or maybe, just maybe, hear me out, is there a glitch in the Matrix?
Déjà vu.
All right, if you guys are into cool science stories, cool science videos, subscribe. We're gonna be doing a lot more stuff just like this. I'm Justin, I'll catch you guys later.